Hey everyone, it's Cass. Welcome back to Madness Returns. This is episode 5. We left off in the Vale of Doom, and now we're in the Oriental Grove. And this is a voiceover I'm doing right now, because maybe as you can see as the game is starting, I plugged in a Switch to start being able to play on that, but I never double-checked that my mic was working again, so I just went into this entire situation thinking it was working. So unfortunately, this whole playthrough is just me in the corner mouthing things that you won't be able to hear, but please enjoy. I promise I fix it, and it will be better for the next one, but enjoy, and I'll see you guys later.
The author obliterated the distinction between poetry and pessimism.
Thank you. Whoever said true art serves neither ornament nor use is ignorant of the aesthetic of the East.
Dodgson is a pathetic sailor and an even worse captain. We'd have run aground on the Isis if I hadn't taken an oar.
Nurse Witless said was, the fire whooshed in, lit her up like the guy on Cracker Night. No one knows how she survived except Alice, and she's stoom, remember.
Thank you. smells are one off. You'd never mistake burning human flesh for roasting a lamb chop.
She who saves a single soul saves the universe. Remember?
Thank you.
she the chosen one?
Our savior?
Our benefactor! It's Alice, the magnificent, the powerful, the brave, the reckless, the rash, the crazy, the imprudent!
Speak with the Elder.
Yes, you really must.
He knows things. He even thinks things.
We'll keep just the one lamp, Alice, as a nightlight, but it stays in the upstairs hall and only till you turn 12.
Your victories in combat and conundrum suggest your fitness to confront the challenges ahead. Mental strength will confirm your worthiness, or declare your defeat.
Thank you.
You can save us. I'll open the path.
Odd things, and she has a hero complex, an inherent desire to help others, being unable to help herself, and a compulsion to make the world right. She's trying to unlock the true meaning of her life, and she doesn't know who has the key.
Wicked wasps lay siege upon us and control the peaks to east and west. You must defeat them to reach Caterpillar's retreat.
I suppose I must go to the mountaintop, as it won't come to me.
We have faith that Caterpillar, the strange and wondrous, helps those in need. One day we'll have proof. Purity of heart is to will one thing, to approach his sacred eyrie. You must confront the savage daimyos. You prevent our access to his power. I'll open the entrance to the sacred caves where your journey begins.
Regard this depiction of domestic harmony and order. The fruitful landscape encouraged industry, tolerance, and cooperation. Loving families flourished, happy children, dear friends, grateful for their well-being, lived for generations, secure, active, and free. But a sudden onslaught of alien attacks broke their fragile bodies and nearly crushed their generous spirits.
Only the foolish believe suffering is just wages for being different.
Beautiful, honorable daughter would commemorate her deceased family in marble. I know a gifted sculptor with whom I might negotiate a commission.
There's no time to waste. There's no time at all.
Radcliffe asked me in just the once. Odd duck. Very proud of his artifacts. Ming, I think he said. And partial to Tokugawa Japan. Doesn't seem the samurai type, but perhaps that's why.
The conflagration's point of origin was obvious. First, the library caught fire, and it spread disastrously when the gas line exploded.
Saved my life. I survived because she showed me how to escape. I didn't leave the lamp in the library, and Dinah didn't knock it over. The lamp and Dinah were upstairs when I went to bed. Dinah was in the room with me when the fire started.
Oh, great caterpillar, why have you abandoned us? The door ahead is sealed. Only by playing the correct sequence of bells can it be opened.
A dubious honor, I suspect. Embedded in my memory, like Twinkle Twinkle Little Bat.
Get to the tree, Alice! Help our brothers!
Thank you. A bridge will complete the path, but this substance has blocked the way. Can you help us to remove it?
I believe I've got the proper tool.
At the top of the mountain, you will find the entrance to the next sacred cave.
Come on.
our benefactor.
You're free, my friends.
Flush the unpleasant from your mind, Alice. Reject the painful as you would the repulsive and depraved. Forgetting is...
The grateful most often confer benefit to the source of their gratitude.
The tree branch makes a bridge, and it's not much of a drop. Keep our secret, Alice, or we're not sisters.
Observe, learn, and react.
Fire, Alice! Fire!
Save yourself! Wake up, Lizzie! Lizzie! Open the door!
The key, Lizzie! Unlock the door! You'll burn!
There's no time to waste! There's no time at all!
Train.
The belligerents, without true cause or purpose, abused and murdered their pacific victims, whom they hated for being different. The invaders corrupted the vivid world. The assaulted could not comprehend the masses' brutality. Still, they stayed on, trying to placate their oppressors and recover their past. The cruel interlopers attacked at intervals instead of killing them all at once. The wretched survivors suffered in perpetual fear. Is there a worse fate?
Yeah.
Once more, the shadow dragon winds along the path. Follow the dragon, Alice.
Ah, I see how it goes. Makes perfect sense, really. At least now it does.
Thank you.
The gate is opened. Now it appears that I can continue my ascent to the peak.
It's not enough that they abuse and murder us. They let their spawn feed on our rotting corpses.
Lovers often exchange a lock of hair to symbolize their vows. Human heart is opened by a vast assortment of keys.
You there, come close. I can recite Red Riding Hood backward. I know my multiplication tables, 2 elevens. I have intelligence.
Really? Persuade me.
To remove the obstruction, wake the frog and empty his belly.
Wake that? What about its tongue? And the prospect of warts? Ooh. Anyway, how do you know?
I imagined how it was done while I was sleeping.
I rang that gong, he'll wake up.
Savage regard the endurance of pain as the measure of worth.
Regrettably, the creature has to die for its image to be properly captured. The subjects of art often suffer.
A restless seeker on private business arrived in the misery-infested land. She, despite ignorance, uncertainty, and unhappiness in her own life, could not endure to see them suffering. She began to fight against the savage murderers, abusers, and defilers without quite knowing why or for whose sake she truly fought or how the struggle would end.
I've come all this way to find a simulacrum.
If I had the time, I'd detail how often you prefer dealing with illusions rather than the real thing. Problems you refuse to deal with don't exist. You deny reality.
That's not right. I know what's real.
No? Then you allow others to tell you what isn't real. Now, come inside.
My memories are shattered. This wicked train has ruined nearly all I can recall. And Wonderland will perish completely as I lose my mind. So much has changed. I can't help Wonderland if I can't help myself.
Much has changed, but you've got it backwards. Save Wonderland and you may save yourself. The carpenter was onto something, but he was hiding from the real. Your goal is to accept it.
Where should I go then? What should I do?
The Queen must be served, Alice. The Queen, in all her guises, must always be served.
How can she stem this growing corruption or assist my search? What does she know that I don't?
She is someone you once knew and loved. Time changes us all.
Not all change is good.
Remember that when you find the Queen. Time changes us all.
You there. That's enough of that. Coming a regular this, Nick Ellis. What's this time, Fred?
Howling outside the old lady, muttering about a murder in Threadneedle Street, cursing insects on the National Railroad. Had to bring her in, didn't I?
Cha-cha-cha-cha, menace to herself. But no danger to have her, surely. She don't belong in jail.
Too true, but where then does she belong?
Let's walk her out, Fred. Send her back to Dr. Bambi. He raised holy hell last time I kept her overnight.
Oh, what happened?
Same night Jack splattered at the waste of mother's love was nabbed for gutting that heavy outside a mermaid. Yeah, I was taking Alice down and we meet two coppers walking Jack to the cells. He's mad in the usual I never wrong bloke nonsense when he sees Alice. That's a bitch what done it, he yells. She screams, you miserable cur, you leech, you maggot, living off another's labour, etc., etc. I'm admiring her line of inquiry, but suddenly she hits her head or something and faints. Couldn't send her home, could I?
And Dr. Bumby pitched a fit.
Said he'd have me jobbing me arse on a plate. Told him he could have the former. Leave the latter alone, thank you very much. Good night, Alice. You know the way out.